Have you ever tried to master SSTOs in KSP2? Did you get frustrated with all the floppy parts? Well, you aren't alone. I'm going to show you how I overcame this challenge and finally mastered SSTOs in KSP2. And I'm going to show you how you can improve yours as well. Let's get started. First things first, you're going to want to build a shell of a SSTO that you can build upon, such as the one that I'm building in the background right now. Second, you're going to want to go into structures, grab some struts, and literally slather them all over the ship. And when I mean slather them all over your ship, I literally mean all over. Every last one of these little pieces that you add onto your ship needs to be strutted down and connected to the main fuselage, or it's not going to work very well. Yes, even the tanks that you put next to the fuselage have to be connected. And for good measure, connect the tailplanes together too. Because yes, you are going to need them. Now, the Jokester 1 is ready for flight. It's actually holding together. It's not drooping. Yes, the runway is still like a Canadian highway, but we'll probably be able to take off now. Eventually, we'll gain enough speed where we can actually take off. Or we can just use this as a ramp. Check that out. Whoa!
I guess we'll just have to add more struts then.
But look, it's still flying. Wow, isn't that nuts? So, we saw that last time this section of the wing broke off, so maybe we should go into structures again, and maybe we should just reinforce those a little bit, like that. Also, I loaded the craft, so we're probably going to have to reinforce everything again, because when you reload a craft, the struts are ignored. So, let's add more struts. Just keep going. If you think there's enough struts, believe me, there aren't. Just keep going until every last inch of this plane is like attached, like even these two. Just do it just in case, you never know. Also, if you put them underneath the plane, you won't see them, which is why I do it. It makes it a little bit nicer to look at. See, we'll add a couple more here too on the top. So now that the plane is completely filled with these struts, I think the Jokester 2 is ready to fly. It's still bouncy, but it's less bouncy than last time. So let's give this a shot. Make sure you have enough surface area on your wings. Otherwise, you won't be able to pull up and you'll have to use a ramp. Oh, or that'll happen. I think the wheel is on crooked or something because this is not going right. Oh, well, there we go. You just have to turn the other way. It's like that scene in Cars, you know? Left to go right, right to go left. There we go. Just in time. Look at that. Look, our wing is together. We're not dying. So now I'm just going to flatten out. We'll gain speed. So now that we're up to speed, we're going to start our sharp turn. I was sure it was going to blow up there. Now that we're at a sufficient speed, we're going to pitch up again, and we're going to go up at 20 degrees. Bonus tip, make sure you set up your hotkeys for switching the cycles. Uh-oh, we're flipping. Okay, so I've completely redesigned our whole thing here. So let's give it a try. I've redesigned everything from the ground up. So we've got tons of fuel. We should be getting to orbit with this bad boy. So we're gonna get up to like 160. I've tested it a bit. It should take off at about 160 or so. And we've got the front wheel off. Yeah! Look at that. We're gonna set up our center engines to like 10 degrees for a little while just to get some altitude. It'll just happily sit there. Okay, so we're gonna get up to about 450, 500 surface speed. Okay, we're at 500, so oops. We didn't have enough struts. See, this is why you can never have too many struts. Look at that beautiful thing. Wow. We're gonna let it gain in speed and altitude. Look at those dudes in there. They're loving their trip right now in our fancy new SSTO. They don't have any worries. We're at 70. We're gonna keep going. We're gonna push it to 80. So we're at 80. This is gonna be fantastic. Let's take a look at our nav ball. Wow, look at that. Okay, so our burn time is about 35 seconds. So we wanna split that in half. So that's gonna be about now. So you can see our periaps is quickly dropping. Our fuel, we've got tons of fuel, dude. We might even be able to make it to the moon. Wow, look at that. 1500. I wonder, would we be able to get to the moon? Back is the difficult part, right? We've got plenty of fuel. We can do it. So when is this burn? Go. We're gonna push our nose out. towards the moon. Can we do it? Leave your comments in the section below. Let's see if we can do it. Looks like we're gonna get to the moon, but will we be able to get back? That's the question. There's the Mun. Entered Mun's SOI. We're not going to get as close as I thought we were going to be. And man, that readout was vastly wrong on the amount of delta V we would have needed. Well, guys, look at this. We're at the Mun. And these guys are also at the Mun. I kind of got them stuck there too. Anyway, we made it to the Mun. We probably need more fuel, so maybe we'll do it another day. I didn't think we'd make it this far to the Mun, in all honesty.
If you liked this video, you'll definitely like the one up on the screen. Now. I hope this helped you with SSTOs. Make sure you like and subscribe for more.
Like, every last inch of that ship needs to be covered in struts, and I just got a bug.